Hi everyone, my name is Rayanne Haynes. I met Hugh a few years ago when he joined me in Edmonton, Canada for the Edmonton Poetry Festival. And I'm now in Edinburgh, completing my master's degree and working on my dissertation. And he and I reconnected on Facebook and he asked me to take part in this project, which I'm delighted to do. So the poem that I am choosing to read really speaks to heritage. I feel like being in this place, I'm surrounded by a heritage that I didn't know for a long time, for most of my life. And so the poem that I'm reading really kind of questions that as well and asks about heritage, or feels that way to me. And the poem is also coming out in the spring in a new collection that I have coming out with Frontenac House. The poem is called "Don't Fall for Imitation Pearls with Exotic Names." In the room where my father hid his most important memories, a box sat in the corner, filled with my great-grandmother's pearls and silver, the items wrapped in white tissue paper and flat cotton, packed away before her death, these false mementos of stature, the silver chipped, pearls flaked, still more precious than gold, treasures gifted by a husband she married while still a girl in braids, her skin darkened by the sun, hands already calloused from working the land. In the room under the stairs where my father hid these things, dust coated the walls and the boxes mother forbade us to touch. In the same room, my mother stored laundry detergent, cat litter, the good holiday ornaments. Mother would say, knowing an object is safe is more important than having it on display. Objects hold memories, you see, and father only had a few. My sister and I would wrap our necks in these remembrances when left unsupervised, or hide under the stairs, dreaming of husbands gifting us with rubies. The jewelry I own is spread haphazardly across my dresser. Items found on travels to countries my great-grandmother never visited, but maybe wanted to, who knows? I never met her to ask. All my memories are wrapped in whirlwinds of adventure, all of them worth far more than the cost of a plane ride, most purchased on the side of a road. I wonder if my sons will hold them dear. I often dream of a house overlooking a valley, built by my great-grandparents' hands. I dream they'd sit on the porch, sharing whiskey and cigars, both covered in dust. Great-grandmother reserving her cleanliness for Sunday morning when God and parish paid attention. This refuge, hewn by hard work, before the city moved in, when the midnight moon was a cotton ball and coyotes outnumbered people and the world was small and we knew how to love each other. Behind their house now, there is an Esso station. In front, a five-story brick apartment. People's memories stacked upon each other like cardboard boxes. My great-grandmother, only ever a ghost to me, is buried in the graveyard half a mile away. Her baubles still hidden under the stairs. My mother still protecting them. Thank you, Hugh.